Hey guys, welcome back to the next episode of Urban Design on City Skylines with me, Praised. We're here in our lovely town of Verrucchio, the ever-expanding town, or should I say city now, of Verrucchio. And since last episode, we've done quite a lot of streaming, actually, and we've avoided quite a few little incidents that we've had to fix up. Let me just start off with... As you may have remembered from earlier episodes, we were actually having a few issues with our airport. When we placed down our airport, we were actually having some issues with having a lot of airplanes arriving at our airport with zero passengers. Yet we were still receiving a lot of airplanes with, or should I say not lots, but at least a couple of airplanes that had actual passengers. And that's because we had some sort of an issue. I'm not exactly sure what glitch or what actually broke in the game. But yeah, something with our public transportation system actually broke down. And this city was very close to not continuing because public transport is one of the main things part of this game that we want to also focus on. Especially with this lovely city. And now... One thing that we also realized was it wasn't only affecting our airport, it was also affecting our bus services and our metro services. And what was happening was the trains would, the correct metro trains or buses would actually arrive at the station that they were going to or supposed to visit to pick up passengers. And they would stop and the boarding little sign would indicate on the actual bus or metro service. And they wouldn't pick anyone up, even though the people were on the right line and the right bus and the right bus was on the right bus station. It wasn't picking it up, them up. And this was some sort of bug. And thankfully, though, we've been able to resolve it thanks to Tritium Cascade. He really helped me out. It ended up being where we had to download a mod, which it's not the extended UI panels for the public transport, but it's the... I can't remember what it is exactly. I'll make sure I do, though, try and link it, just in case if you guys have got similar issues where your public transport aren't picking up passengers, or you've got an excess amount of ships or airplanes arriving with zero passengers into your city. It's one of the mods which gives you more control over your public transport. It's like the full-on control public transport mod, which allows you to control like even like how many specific... vehicles you have operating on a certain line. And so what we did was pretty much we activated that mod and things started working back to normal. So once that happened, we actually saved the game, we came out of it, and then we deactivated the mod and then went back into the game and the game was all fixed. So the reason why I deactivated it was because I didn't want that much control over the public transport system, at least not at this stage yet. Later on during the series, we might dive into that sort of high intense information of our public transport system, of how many specific buses or metro or train lines or trains services we want on every specific line. But for now, we're just letting the budget do all the work for us. We're just going to be adjusting the budget as we need it. So while we had those issues, we did do quite a little bit of progress. Not too much because we were a bit stagnant because of that issue, but we did have a few disasters as well. So if you go back to the Twitch sessions, you might see that we were actually having quite a few problems after the new dam was established, because I was messing around with water spawners so that we can get more water flowing into our new dam. And by accident, I actually placed an extra water spawner somewhere where it shouldn't have, and it pretty much flooded our whole main downtown area. Although nothing was yet developed, so nothing was really lost, but the whole entire lower map was pretty much underwater. Our normal neighborhoods were still high enough, so they survived, but as you remember, we really did lower the downtown area as low as possible to the water level inside the bay. So, but it eventually got fixed up thanks to Daladuck, who actually realized the water spawner. It would just completely, I don't know, by accident placed it, and so our water levels rose. But problem was averted, so, and we fixed the issue. Now, I'll give you guys a bit of a recap. So of what was done. So we've started expanding our industrial area and it's working very well. We've got no traffic real issues. We haven't had to place many roundabouts or any roundabouts at all because the traffic is just flowing very nice and smoothly. So all good with that. We started adding a bit of ore mining into or ore specialization into surrounding the little areas around over here where our generic industry is. Now, our generic industry, some areas are fully upgraded, some are not yet fully upgraded. We'll be fully upgrading them once we continue providing some more services around over here. We did start getting a bit of more residential demand, so we started surrounding our industry with residential demand or some neighborhoods. So I think this area will start looking really nice once it's completely covered with neighborhoods all the way around. Now, our dam is actually now complete, and it's actually pumping out quite a lot. I think we're at 75% budget of our electricity budget, and both dams are providing us just around the 1,000 megawatt mark. So I'm presuming that by the time we actually upgrade them to, or even increase the budget to 100%, that they'll be easily in together, they'll be able to produce at least around the 3,000 megawatt mark. So, which is massive. It's like probably five times the amount of what a nuclear power plant can do. And so that also incrementally just is massively, massively just cheaper to run than compared to a nuclear power plant. Now, one little thing that we have done is we added we just modified this stream back here just outside the actual map where we actually just did a bit of terraforming. That's about it. So we do have our original water spawner up here. And so we lowered the ground. We've got a little, if you can see just on our right side, there's a little bit of a waterfall. It's not even a waterfall. It's just more of a stream that heads down. So there's more force actually heading downstream because we actually do have a water spawner right over here in the middle. And that kind of is here just to facilitate extra water to be pumped into both dams. So that is helping us with that. This current bridge over here is all temporary work with the actual railway connections. However, the highway is all permanent. This whole highway over here, we've been developing it and it's all permanent. It's here to stay. And we've tunneled it actually underneath over here. And we've made a new intersection around here. Now, all connections are not yet completed and not all connected. But for the time being, it's all working and it's all good. So the actual main facility of this highway and design is actually up and running. We just have to decorate it a bit here and there. Now, I'm not sure if we mentioned this, but we did create, I think we did, but just in case I'll re-mention it, we've got the Patja Cloverleaf interchange with my slight modifications. So that's working out really well and we're not having any real big issues with that. We've got the Supray Reverse Interchange, as I may have mentioned before. This is when Supray was annoying me when we were building, so I renamed it after her, since it's also kind of unique. It's very different to what we've had before. Now, this is one accomplishment that I'm very happy. Now, this is going to be called the Deladuck Bridge, or the Deladuck Crossing. I'm still going to come across the name, but it's definitely going to be Deladuck. He suggested that we should connect a road which connects over here into our downtown area. And that's exactly what we are going to be doing and, well, have done. Now, we've done this a little bit differently because, as you may see right over here, we've actually got a train that's passing underneath. So we've actually connected a railway line underneath the actual road bridge itself. So it works, and we've added two railway lines underneath, and it's turned out to look absolutely spectacular, and it's fully functioning as well. So let me just say that on one side of the rail, the one side is actually heading into our, both rails are actually heading into our downtown area where we've got our main train station or our main train terminal. And so one line is for an internal line where we're only operating internal trains, and one is actually connected to external connections. So that's where we are actually getting our external visitors to come into our city through via the trains, at least anyway. So this avenue actually connects all the way out here where we've got Redmond, and it goes all the way through past our industrial area as well, and it connects in over here. Now, one thing that we also have done is we've started working on our downtown a little bit, but not much. So don't worry, we're definitely going to be working a lot more. We've definitely got a lot more work to do in our downtown area. It's only just the beginnings where I've set up a few little main buildings to see what it starts looking like, a few main roads here and there, so that we've got a bit of a guide to see how things are looking. Now, we've also set up our main terminal over here where we've got our main train service. We've got our main bus service, which actually isn't in operation yet. And that's about the downtown area for now. I mean, there's not much really to go on because we've just placed a few couple of buildings here and there, so nothing too fancy just yet. But one thing that I'm liking is that it's fully operational, and especially the sunken highway around over here looks absolutely fantastic, and it's also working very, very well. Now, the next thing that I'd like to focus on is some massive renovations that we've done to our local airport, or should I say our international airport. Now, as you can see, we've pretty much surrounded the whole island with rocks as well. We've got rid of a huge chunk of land around from over here, and where we had some buildings. And we've pretty much done what we were supposed to do from the very beginning, and it looks so much better. What we've done is pretty much done essentially just the tunnel bridge connection. We've got no other things. It was supposed to be just the tunnel bridge connection, and then the idea came across to add the airport. So we've done that. We've added the airport, but other than that, it's just the tunnel bridge connection. Now, the actual connections that run off the highway are connecting only to the airport pretty much. So the airport is pretty much like a main service around over here on this island. However, we have added a few extra things, which I'll get to. Now, this train terminal over here is connected part of our internal network. So what we actually have doing is quite a bit of a sophisticated network, which I actually didn't think would work. But it actually is working fantastically well. I'm just going to quickly pause the game. Now, as you can see, at the top, we've got our international airport, and on the bottom, we've got our internal railway line. And so what I've got is a path actually coming across from the railway line, leading all the way straight and across towards the airport. Now, that was going to be like my main crossing, pretty much from airport to rail, rail to airport. But then it came across the idea that just crossed my mind that people coming from the airport will usually have a lot of luggage and heavy luggage, and they probably last thing that they want to do after a long flight is actually take a bit of a walk across to the internal or to a train terminal. So what I've done is I've just made a little bit of a transit, like an airport rail transit bus network around over here. So what we have over here is people waiting for the bus, and we'll just continue the simulation. So it comes here, it picks up people up from in front of the rail terminal, and so the bus is actually just going to go and stop in front of the airport, where we've got one right over here, and that's the whole bus line. It just goes two stops, one from the railway terminal, one to the airport. And so I think it's just a nice little touch. I actually didn't think that it would be working. I actually seriously thought that people would find it walking to be a lot quicker and easier, but it turns out that this actual little thing is working out a treat. So the buses are pretty much just doing a continuous loop around here servicing this area. Now, because this is a very important station, because this line, internal line, connects the airport and it connects the downtown area and also our industrial area. It also connects to our main residential area around over here. Now, you may remember in Sant'Arcangelo that we had our main train station in Vélez. Now, we've got a new suburb over here called Nueva Vélez, so meaning New Vélez. And because of that kind of achievement that Sant'Arcangelo, especially Vélez, had within Sant'Arcangelo, what we've done is added the new main train station inside Nueva Vélez. And it seems to be working very, very well. And we're getting our bus services around over here, servicing this train station. And not too far away, we've got our metro service, which can interconnect the rest of these outer neighborhoods. So from this metro station, passengers can just quickly jump across towards the train station, and all is well. They can get to pretty much anywhere they want, whether it's the airport, the downtown, or if it's the industrial area. But wait, there's more. This train service also continues. It goes into our farm districts. And so what we've done in our farm districts over here in Millbrook is we've connected a bit of a little small little basic train station, because it's only a little town in our farming zone. So we've connected just a little bit of a small little train network over here. So that's working out very, very well. And it's a bit of a loop, although it's not a full loop, because then it continues to go across and it ends up over here near Riverside, I believe it was called, where we've got our last train station. So this is the end of the line. And so if we head over back in where this train is going, the end of the line where this train will end is in our industrial area. And in our industrial area, if I'll jump back up there quickly and show you, in our industrial area, the actual line ends on a elevated train station right here. And as you can see, we get a lot of people over here. So, but the trains are more than capable of dealing with the large numbers. So this is the good thing. So there we go. As you can see, nearly all the people just have jumped on. And so this train is pretty much getting utilized very, very well. And if we just jump down over here, you can see how much people are pouring out. So the train network is absolutely fantastic. People are jumping into the metro, and then this metro essentially connects up into this industrial area around over here. So our public transport system is working absolutely magically well. Like, I cannot stress how well this is working out. So pretty much I'm not focusing on trains being our main source of travel around the city. They are, however, being a main source of getting across the city. Our metro systems are more kind of localized within quadrants, which are actually servicing smaller areas, well, larger areas. So pretty much what we've built up is a network where buses serve towards the metros and the metros serve towards the trains. So smallest to medium to largest public transport, essentially. And that philosophy has worked out very, very well. But we still have to develop a few areas. Now, one thing that we did, it was the last thing that we did on our stream, this was actually on Friday, we actually added our first cargo freight network into our city. So this is our first proper shipping and cargo freight network, and it seems to be working really well. Now, the goal of this was simple. It was to get, because we have so many freight stations over here in our industrial area. I think we got like four or five. One, two, three. No, we got four. We got four freight train stations in our industrial area. So all four are actually connected up via rail to actually be able to not only go to our external sources, but to also to be able to connect to our dock over here. Now, this dock also connects to the ships, so the ships can provide actual vehicles to come in over here, and then the rail train station can actually go and head into our industrial area. And that's about that. Now, the next thing about this dock is, though, I thought, because we're going to be getting a lot of vans that actually want to produce, or that are producing lots of, our industrial area is producing a lot of vans that actually want to go to commercial zones within all of these neighborhoods. So I decided what would be a good idea is to actually provide access for those vans to use the train to get to here, which will be a lot faster than driving on the highways. And then just using one of these exit loops, which actually out of that industrial area that comes out of over here, which is this little ramp, which just jumps onto this highway network and then heads over and into our zone over here with all our commercial and residential zones. So it's a bit of a quick trip. And also we have, we have also offered the connection to go towards the downtown area with this ramp right here, which actually goes underneath all of this and actually does a bit of overlapping underneath and over the top of this. So it's quite complex. Yeah, it looks very simple, but yeah, it's quite complex. So we've managed to be able to squeeze quite a lot of things into a relatively small area. Something that I'm really liking is this train station. It's a custom mod which I found on the workshop, and it looks absolutely spectacular when it's lit up at night. And we're using this now. This is our main bus depot. Now we're only using one bus depot. I know it's more logical and convenient to use more than one bus depot across the city because, say, for instance, if you open up lines on the other side of the map, it'd be quicker to get buses over there to and from the depot. However, because there's no restrictions on how many buses actually come out of a depot, I see there's no point. I'm actually willing to wait the extra 1 or 2 minutes for the buses to actually get to their routes. Then instead of spending an extra 900 of the currency per week just to maintain a depot. So we're actually gaining or financial benefit by doing it this way, by having only one main depot inside our city. And it's kind of centralized, so it will be able to service the whole entire city quite well, I reckon. And I think that is pretty much about it. We're not having any issues after we've upgraded our highway, so there's no more stress on just the one single solitary highway getting from around our city into our industrial area. It's all the load is pretty much now split up quite well and nice. Now, that's pretty much a recap, and it's a rather large recap, and it happened to be because of the little issues that we were having with public transport, but as you can see, we're not having multitudes of airplanes now running and landing into our city with zero passengers. We're not having multitudes of ships coming in and stacking up like crazy with zero passengers. When we actually have ships arriving now, or airplanes arriving, or our public transport, everything is now running like clockwork with the numbers and proper financials. Now, after the mod also that fixed our city, we have realized that we have had a bit of a population increase. So our population was a little bit off as well. So our game was a bit bugged. I'm not exactly sure for what reason or what happened, but the problem seems to have been fixed, and we can successfully and quite comfortably continue working on this city. Now we're still gonna have to connect some highways into our downtown area, and that's kind of what's holding me back, because until we further continue working on a bit of a grid around over here inside this city, I'm gonna be holding back on that because I need to make sure that I know where exactly it is that I want the highways to be connecting inside the downtown area. Now, one thing that I wanted to do for this episode is we're just going to jump straight into the game. Now, as you can see, we're making quite a lot of money, especially since last episode. We've definitely made a lot more money. Something that we have to still keep monitoring is our sea levels, because I think because we've pushed this so low, and because of the constant water that's coming out of our new dam, and especially if we just have a look at the water strength, you can see that the water is quite powerful over here, and it's heading really quickly into this area. So one thing that I'm considering of doing is modifying the ground underneath over here and sinking the water really low, so that we can kind of slow down the water streams over here, so we can kind of stop the little miniature flooding that we get over here from time to time. So that's going to be one thing on our agenda when we get to it, before we actually fully initialize development in our downtown area. Now, one thing that I wanted to do is perhaps start showing you guys that a few more props that we're going to actually place into our downtown area. So let's see. There's one thing that I actually wanted to do, and that was to place this little shopping center. Now, it's the Walker Shopping Center. Not actually sure where it's from, perhaps somewhere in Canada. But initially, I had this placed right over here where the railway line is, without realizing that we need to continue the railway line to get through. So I've decided that we're going to actually have to place this in a new location. Now, a possibility was actually around over here, right next to the Folos building from Brazil. But then I thought, I'm still not for, but I'm just still thinking that I don't want it too close to that building, because we might want other streets to surround this building, this shopping center. So what I'm going to do is make it like near a big cross intersection like this, where the main entry is on the actual intersection itself, like so. And it's a very, very nice looking building. And it's a building that I want to make sure that can be seen. Because, yeah, it's just a very, very pretty building. So one thing that I want to do now is add some car parks. Because this is a main shopping center, I was thinking of adding car parks all the way in front of this building, like that. And what we're going to do is make sure that because this is going to stay relatively open. Now, I forgot to turn off overlap, so I'm just going to quickly fix this issue up. So I'm just going to quickly upgrade some of these roads so that the overlap doesn't kick in. Now we're going to connect some temporary power lines as well, like so, because this building looks very, very good. Now one thing that I want to consider is seeing what we can actually place. Should we place an avenue around over here? Or if we should place a street? This is one thing that's got me currently in a bit of a stumbling block. Now, just for good old time's sake, I'll place an avenue. Like so. Now, I think that looks really, really good. A nice large car park. And of course, we're going to have quite a few offices around this area. And we do have a small demand for industry and offices. So while we're here, I may as well offer some offices into this area. And we'll see how this expands or starts to develop. Now we've got our health coverage around over here, so that's all good. We've got our fire services, so that's all good. Now one thing that we don't have is police service. So I was considering of actually adding some police services into this area. Now I think this might be a good location right over here. But before we do that, I'm just going to put a couple of spaces across, because one thing that I like to do, well actually we could actually put it right on the corner. Because what I'm thinking is we can utilize the space underneath this railway lines with more car parks. But as you can see, we can't actually place it underneath because the railway lines are in the way. So what we're going to do is jump into overlap mode. Ooh, we still can't. So give me a second. I'm just going to delete these railway lines temporarily. We're going to place our car parks across like that. And now we're going to jump into our railway lines and just connect them up like so. Beautiful. So we're actually utilizing the space underneath these railway lines. And what we can do right here is on the other side, we can pretty much do the same. I'm hoping anyway. We'll have to wait and see. Just give me a second here. Let's add a couple more because we already got a car park over here. I just want to make sure that... I'm sure we can. If we can't do it like this, we'll just go into float mode. And where we can float our... pillars. And let's just go into collide or overlap. Now, this is always going to be clipping now, aren't you? Because you're going to be annoying us. Yes. So, unfortunately, I'm just going to have to place it there. I'm going to have to place, oh sorry, not clipping, snapping. I've already been told off by you guys once that it's not clipping, it's snapping. I'm so used to saying clipping. All right, so we're going to do this as a little bit of a floating segment like that. This as well. Somewhere around that runs kind of evenly, if we can. There we go, from there to there. And now we're going to jump back into pillars. And this rail can connect up like that. Now, this is a bit disjointed around over here. So what I'm going to do... I wasn't supposed to delete that, but okay. And over here, we can just run rails, overlap. Perfect. Now, because of the overlap, it's created like extra boxes on the actual road. So what we just need to do is go back into collide and just downgrade if we have to with some of these streets like so. Like that. Okay. Now, I don't think there's any other streets around here that have actually been affected. No. Okay, all is well. So now I'm just going to have to upgrade them to, or downgrade them, depending which what we did, back to what they were, like so. And all is well. And these spaces underneath will actually get utilized. So we're going to be heading into our sunset soon. So we'll be able to see how the little new car parks underneath our railway lines actually look. And hopefully they'll start actually getting used. They will be getting utilized. And this area as well over here. And I'd like to see what this new shopping center looks like at night as well. I think it will look rather good, to say the least, I think. Okay, so I guess we just have to wait a little bit. Now, I was considering of adding a small little water feature around over here. Now, I'll show you what I mean by water feature. Over here in this industrial area, we added a bit of a small water feature like this. I really like it. It really doesn't serve any purpose, apart from just it looks pretty nice. So, I'm actually considering of doing the same over here in this little segment. Just for the design, just for the feel of it. And perhaps add a few of these, where do we have it? A few of these shorefront kind of parks on the side. Now that's an idea that's floating around my head, but I want to make sure that it's not too small and not too big. Let me know what you guys potentially think about that idea, because it's something that I wouldn't mind actually doing, because we've been enjoying actually the work that we've been doing with our water and terraforming in this city. We've actually been doing quite a lot, and it really does help to make your cities work even better. Now this shopping center actually does look very, very good. It's beautifully lit up, actually. Absolutely sensational. I really do like it, especially the colored pillars. It makes it look very good. The big car park at the front, that will eventually get used. It already is right over here. One person's already here, so that's good. Now, next to these railway lines, I'm thinking the best thing to place next to these railway lines will be our offer zones. Offer zones work pretty good when it comes to isolating noise pollution. So for that reason, we will continue to add some more office zones like this. And then when we move away from the railway lines, we'll start probably adding not only more offices, but some more commercial zones as well. I'm not really fond of having too much residential into this area. Now, main residential areas are going to be on the outskirts of the city. We might have a bit of higher density on this island. Maybe it's still a consideration. But for the time being, all this is going to be serving as a main service of jobs, pretty much. I think that's what a main CBD is purpose is to be, to have jobs. Although large metropolitan cities do have a lot of high-rise residential buildings. But for now, we're just going to be sticking to providing office space and commercial, because I know when the city further expands, a lot more demand is required for office, industrial, and commercial, and I don't want to be using them out into the outskirts of the city when we've developed like residential on the main island. I'd rather keep this as mainly the center point of the city where most people come to work. And if we do require, once this is all completely filled up and the other island, and we still do have that kind of demand, then we'll actually start considering of actually adding extra services of that type into outer suburbs as we go. Now over here, I've decided to make like a bit of a downtown little central park in this little cube or rectangular area. And then what I found was this building fits perfectly in between both of these parks. So I decided to at least put one skyscraper that's going to be joined up with the central park over here. So there we go. Let's see, can we add a bit more progress into the city over here? I think we can, right? Why not? Now, I'm not going to be focusing on public transport anytime soon right now in this downtown area. First, what we're going to be doing is expanding it. And once it's going to be mostly expanded and we've got our other highway connections actually coming in, and speaking of that, we still need to work on our highway connections with these highways over here. But once all that is going to be done, we'll actually start and have... We will start and progressing into having the idea of implementing some mass transit inside this island when it's got to do with our metro and with our bus services. So we'll have all the services connecting over here. For the time being, all we have is just our train service, which connects into our downtown area. So yeah, that's about it. It's a bit of a recap episode. We did tiny amount of work, just a little bit here. It's because we've had so much just work off camera that we did, because we were struggling to get the city back up and running with the little bugs that we were having with the public transport. But with all of that fixed, I must say I'm very, 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 very happy with the way things are turning out. I was really close to calling the quits on this city because of that problem, but I'm so happy that we were able to fix the problem. And the city has just, after that moment, just developed so much. Like, this airport island has developed so much. It looks 150 times better than what it was before. And its just main function is just working really, really well, especially with the train network and the airport, the way they are linked together. It's just fantastic. It's got me really excited for the future progression of this city, and just the way our downtown area is already starting to take shape. And with so many more skyscrapers going to be placed around over here, and with our little commercial strip around over here with our hotels, tall high-rise hotels, and our little beachfront over here with palm trees, but it's going to be a little nice mixture. And I'm just absolutely really looking forward to the progress that we're going to be making. Now, for all new people maybe watching this episode, I hope you kind of have enjoyed this little recap slash little tiny bit of development on this city. Now, I will be streaming less because, as many of you guys have known, I actually am going to be starting a new job as of tomorrow, which is Monday or Tuesday when this episode will be released, so yesterday most likely. And so it's a normal Monday to Friday job, so our normal streaming days of Monday and Thursday will not be continuing for the foreseeable future. But what we will be trying to do is perhaps be streaming on weekends. And if a stream is actually going to be happening on a weekend, please make sure to like the Facebook page. The link will be down in the description below. Whenever I'm going to be jumping on streaming, I tend to leave a bit of a notice at least the day before so that you guys can be aware of what time and when the stream will be jumping on. That's probably your best bet of knowing if you want to watch some live action of development of the city. Other than that, it's mostly predominantly going to be going back to the way we were doing things, and that's working mostly on YouTube. So there might be a bit of development happening off camera, if not on Twitch. But don't worry, I will be doing it just like before, explaining everything that was done in preparation for the next episode. Now guys, if you are keen to follow any live streams on Twitch, don't forget to follow us or follow me on the Twitch. The description is down below. And for any of the continued following supporters, thank you for your support. Thank you for those hardcore followers as well that have really been helping me, giving me nice ideas on how to further progress this city, and also coming up with the solution to you, Cascade, especially. Thank you so much on providing me with that solution with the public transport. Shout out also to Uncle for being an awesome moderator on the Twitch streams for me, and also Della Duck as well, who's been constantly posting me messages on my Facebook page about some great ideas and architectural designs that I've been trying to implement as best as I can, also with a few of my implementations mixed in with his, so that the city can progress further. So, and all the rest that I may have not mentioned, thank you for your continued support. Please give us a thumbs up if you're enjoying this series as well. It'll give me great motivation to continue Not that I don't have enough at the moment, because I have plenty. But yeah, I'll try and keep you guys in the loop as well, how the new job is going. And yeah, that's about it. Exciting times, because now we are getting very close pretty much. We're pretty much at the period where we are going to be starting to work on our downtown area. So without further ado, I guess it's goodbye for now. I'll see you very, very soon for the next episode. Bye-bye for now, guys.